Welcome to Accounting Europe YouTube channel.
Hello. Today we're going to be talking about withholding tax on rent and handle the peculiarities around treating such. Now, there are two scenarios that could possibly happen, which we painted here. A situation whereby a vendor issues you an invoice of 2 million, but has clearly stated that the invoice is net of all taxes, including withholding tax. Now, the first thing we need to know is that withholding tax is about on rent is 10%. Now, in such scenario, if the vendor has specified that he's going to get 2 million, and that means that amount cannot change, meaning that we need to gross up this particular amount to factor in if the full value before withholding tax was deducted. How do we do that? Now, we're saying withholding is 10%, meaning that this value as seen here is less withholding tax already, meaning that this figure is actually 90% of the full value of what the invoice should be. So if that is 90%, you divide this by 0.9. That is a simple way to gross it up. Right, if we do this figure times 10%, this will be our WHT. So that if we do the full value less this, we get our net of WHT. Now, this is the amount that will remit as withholding tax in this particular scenario. Now, one key thing we need to take note is that the full entries to capture this transaction will be that for rent, usually is usually prepaid, so we debit our prepaid expense, which is a current asset. The full value, we credit the vendor the amount less withholding tax, and we credit our WHT to 222,000, so that everything is complete. Take note, this has increased our costs by the amount of withholding tax, and the vendor actually has a title to this withholding tax. If you remit it, you are required to give him to pay it in his name, and he gets the credit note for it at the end of the period. Now, the other scenario is this, which is here, 250, where the vendor has charged us inclusive of VAT and the rest. First, we need to tell ourselves that this amount includes VAT, meaning that the amount less VAT will be 1 divided by 1.075, where we see 7.5% is the new withholding tax rate, VAT rate. So that means that this is the contract amount, VAT at 7.5%, this times 7.5%. And this plus this will give you the full value, which is what we have above. It's on this amount, colored in red, that we would pay withholding tax on. So this times 10%, which is our VAT withholding tax rate. So we come here and do this. Right. So these are WHT. So the amount less WHT will be this less this is 1950. In this particular scenario, we debit prepaid expense. Let's copy this with the full invoice value. Credit the vendor. It's 1950. And credit WHT payable. 200,000. Now we just need to. This is a very common scenario. The reason why we need to be careful about withholding tax on rent is that we know that for most businesses, the rent of their property, staff costs, some businesses, professional fees are like one of the major top highest cost in most likely in the operating cost of a business. So during a tax audit, ability to properly remit what is meant for withholding for rent is key. Because just imagine the tax authority slamming 10% on your rent, which you've paid 20 million on. That's 2 million. You know, include interest and penalty. So for us to be compliant, we need to be careful when treating withholding tax on rent and based on the various scenarios. Do not, because of he has told you that it's exclusive of withholding tax, pay this amount and not pay withholding tax. Otherwise, you'll be exposed sometime in the future.